And joining us this morning, we have Dr. Scott Robertson. It's always great when you come in. And
I'm glad to be here. You know, today I get to sit in Randall's chair.
That's right.
You know, it's very luxurious.
Feels very comfortable having you
here. I think he's got like a chair warmer or something going on here. You know,
it's keeping it ready for him for
exactly,
when he returns.
Exactly. So, you know, I have to act extra professional today.
There you go. And today we're talking about seasonal allergies. This seems like it's something that might be a little close to you.
Yeah, I have a little bit of congestion, a little bit of runny nose. And this is the time of year, you know, we see a lot of people coming into my office that really have serious seasonal allergies this time of year. And they're always extremely frustrated about what they can do, what they can't do. And I'm always surprised that a lot of folks come in and haven't done a lot of the work that they could be doing at home. If you have a runny nose, itchy, watery eyes, scratchy throat, or even hives, you could be suffering from seasonal allergies. However, take comfort in knowing that you're not alone. When you combine the winter rains and recent winds and sunshine, you have flowers and grasses in bloom, and you might just get a big dose of allergic misery. Now, before you pack up your bags and leave town, I have a few tips that may help your seasonal allergy problem. The best way to prevent allergies is to avoid the things you are allergic to. Now, I know that's easier said than done, but a few simple steps around the house could make you feel better. First, keep your doors and windows closed, especially on windy days. And if you have air conditioning in your home or car, turn it on when the pollen counts are high. Also, don't hang your laundry outside to dry, as wet clothing can pick up pollen and molds in the air. Wear a dust mask when you're out doing yard work. And lastly, try to limit early morning outdoor activities. This is typically the time of day when the pollen counts are the highest. There are times, however, when either these steps are not enough or just not practical, and you may need a little medical intervention. Fortunately, non-sedating antihistamines such as Claritin and Zyrtec are available over the counter, and the generic versions are very inexpensive, well tolerated, and very effective. If these medications are not helpful, then you may need to try some prescription solutions. The cornerstone of prescription treatment for seasonal allergies are nasal corticosteroids. Sold under the brand names like Flonase or Nasacort, these medications are the best at fighting the nasal symptoms of allergies, such as runny nose and congestion. And Flonase is now available as generic. If you have other symptoms like itchy or watery eyes or even hives, you may need to change to a different oral medication such as Singulair or even a short course of prednisone to help with the problems that aren't responding to the conventional treatment. If despite following all of these simple steps, you're still miserable, a trip to the allergist may be in order. However, be prepared to undergo a series of diagnostic testings in order to figure out the exact cause and the best course of treatment for your allergy problem. And so, Sarah, you know, a lot of folks coming in to the office, like I said, you know, they may not do a lot of some of these home things that they could be doing, such as keeping their windows closed on windy days. If you do have an air conditioning system in your house, which not a lot of people do on the Central Coast, mm-hmm. but certainly running that can help clear some of the molds and pollens out of your house.
Okay.
And then using the over-the-counter medications. Medications like the generic Claritin or Zyrtec mm-hmm. are very effective for people. And they can be a really good solution, especially if you haven't tried them. Now, you do need to take them every day, maybe for a couple weeks until your symptoms fully resolve, but certainly they can be very safe for folks and very effective as well. And some people still don't get over the hump even mm-hmm. with trying these medications. So you may need to see your doctor to see if you want to try something like the generic Flonase, for instance, which is a good first step.
Okay.
This largely is effective for the nasal symptoms, the runny nose, congestion, that just kind of mm-hmm. sense of phlegm that you get in the
yeah.
back of your throat when your allergies are really flaring up. Another common thing that I see is people come in and they may have never had allergies their whole life, or they may have moved here from another part of the country, and all of a sudden they're getting the seasonal allergies. Yeah. You certainly can become allergic to things mm-hmm. as you get older, or as you become more exposed to okay. certain types of things that are in the environment.
Mm-hmm.
Another problem that we have here on the Central Coast is that there's never really a dormant season. We don't really have deep freezes here like you might see in other places of the country. Mm-hmm. And so there's never really a time where all of the plants are completely dormant. They mm-hmm. always have something in bloom. There's a lot of agriculture in mm-hmm. the area, even during the winter months. Mm-hmm. So that can cause issues. And we also have a lot of non-native plants that are highly allergenic, things
okay.
like citrus
mm-hmm.
And olive trees, which you see a lot here in either Santa Barbara or San Luis Obispo County, can really be a problem for a lot of folks.
Okay. And then I did want to just get to this really quick. I know we're running out of time, but we did get a question in from Cruz and Bros Hernandez. I have had seasonal allergies since I was a kid. Now that I'm older, it seems like I have allergies all year long. The worst in the spring. Right now, really bothering me, the itchy, watery eyes. One, nonstop under the skin, under the eye, very tender. And what can I do to make the watering in my eyes stop?
Yeah, start with a Claritin or Zyrtec. You may want to try some saline eye drops. That could be helpful for you.
Okay. All right. And Ambrosia wrote that in. Thank you so much for sending in the questions. And, of course, if you have more questions to your health, you can send it to morningrounds@kcoy.com. As always, we love seeing you here. Dr. Scott Robertson, thank you for joining us. And we'll be right back.